Hello there, welcome back to another episode of Pimp My Filter. This is probably number 40-odd, 50-odd or something by this point. I've lost count. But today we're going to be taking a look at another Oase filter. So this is the Thermo version of the Biomaster 850. And the other one we took a look at in this range was previously the biggest one. That was a 600. Since then, Oase have released a bigger version. It's not really any different to the 600, but it is a little bit bigger, so it is for more serious, bigger tanks. You know, a lot of discus people are putting these in, a lot of folks who are doing good aquascapes are putting them in. In fact, George Farmer took a look at one of these in one of his videos. He's probably one of the most famous aquascapers in the UK. Seems to be a really good guy, makes good videos. Check him out. This video will be my take on it because I've already taken a look at the 600. There is two specific changes that I want to see in this model because it is an addition to the existing range. Now the first change I would like to see in this one is in the pre-filter part of it, which you'll see in a moment. Originally the foams in there were quite fine, so they would clog quickly. I actually swapped them out for a coarse foam in the previous video, which I cut from the foams that came in the trays. I'm hoping I don't have to do that because that was a right fart on and it's unnecessary. They should have swapped the foams to a more coarse foam. The second change I would have liked to have seen is also in that pre-filter part. There was a little skinny pipe went down inside those pre-filter foams and it was very narrow. It was probably about half an inch or 12 mil diameter and it didn't have many holes in. That was restricting the flow. If you remember from the previous video, I drilled loads of holes in there to increase the flow. People who've done that say that it works a treat. It does increase the flow. So they're the two changes I would like to see. And that's before we get to what should be in where the foams are and where the filter media is. From the videos other people have put out, I can see that they haven't changed that at all. So I wasn't expecting a change there. But nothing's really been mentioned about the pre-filter thing, so I'm interested to have a look. Let's get it on the table. I'll show you how it works, just for those folks who haven't seen the 600 video, and then we'll take a look inside. This doesn't have a very big footprint, so it doesn't take up much space actually on the ground, but as you can see, it's the skyscraper of canister filters. It really is quite tall. Exact dimensions will be in the links that I put in the video description. In fact, anything I talk about here that's of relevance will be linked in the video description. So bring that up if you want extra information. This, I can see, is just as well made as the 600. It's got a really strong, flush-fitting carrying handle. It's actually a beautifully designed filter. I will give Oase that. It's really, really good. The stuff that was in the 600 that didn't really impress me. The construction of it and the way the water flows did impress me. This one is exactly the same, really. Bring the camera in, let you have a look at the top, and I'll explain further. Okay, so that is the in pipe. That draws water from the tank. It goes through the pre-filter, which is inside of here, which also has a primer button on the top. You can hear the little flap going backwards and forwards, which will create the one-way flow. And then it goes to the bottom of the filter, rises up through the trays, and at the same time, it rises up through a little bit of a pipe here, where there is a 400-watt heater sitting. And just to clarify something about the heater, a lot of people get confused about this and complain that it doesn't keep the water up to the temperature. That's because they're using these filters in tanks that are really too big for this heater. This is a 400 watt heater in this model, so that would make it suitable for tanks up to 400 litres if you wanted to keep them up to temperature. Normally you would allow 1 watt of power per litre, and for you guys in the US, you can convert that into gallons. I don't know what that is off the top of my head. It's very easy for us guys in the UK, working in tens. 1 watt of power per litre, easy to remember. Here, we've got that lovely strong handle, and when it's in the down position, it actually puts a little bit of pressure on this clip And this clip, just to keep everything pulled down that little bit more. So in order to get these clips off, you lift that up and then you can release the lid. We've also got the same clips on the side of here as well. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. I'll just take this heater out just in case I damage it when I'm lifting the top off. And I don't want to damage this because it isn't my filter. As you can see, that's quite a long heater. Oh God, I nearly dropped it there. You see what I mean? I've got to get it out of the way. And that is a 400 watt heater. Right. Let's get this off. Now the pump in here is 32 watts. Obviously that isn't a very high running cost for the pump. The flow is 1500 litres per hour. I'll put all the conversions for this in the video description for you guys in the US and elsewhere. And the heater is 400 watts. So obviously the lion's share of the electrical input is going into the heater. And the good thing about it being in there is it keeps it out of the tank. So it's not going to get damaged. It's really convenient to manage it there as well. This is just a bloody good filter. Before we take the lid off, let's get the pre-filter out. So we've got a lock here. Unlock that. That also shuts the water off going to here. We've got a lock here, and that will allow this just to lift out. It's got a little flap, one-way valve in the bottom. You can take this out to a sink, pop this off, clean it, and then just slot it back in, lock, switch it on, and you're away again. Remember that the water flows from bottom to top, so everything that's kind of been explained here will be in reverse as far as the water flow is concerned. In here we've got a medium density pad in quite a shallow tray, which could be used for like a post-filtering chemical media like carbon or something. Fit quite conveniently in there. You've got a nice strong tray on the top to stop anything being sucked into the pump head. Underneath that, you've got a block of coarse foam. Good quality foam. Doesn't do much as far as actual bacteria holding goes. Next tray, the same. Next tray, the same. Whoa. Next tray, the same. Gone overboard with the foam in this one. Next tray is probably about 150 to 200 grams of Hell X13 media. This is an excellent moving bed media. So you'd use it in kind of Nexus filters, homemade moving bed filters and so on. Very, very good. No good as a static media because it just doesn't have enough surface area. Plastic is a hostile environment. We need something like ceramic or sintered glass in here just to support bacteria much more efficiently than plastic. And then the very bottom tray is just the same. So, in summary, we have from bottom to top a little bit of Helix, a little bit more Helix, coarse foam, medium foam. As it is, that's okay. You know, it's good quality foam and it will support an amount of bacteria, just not enough for even moderately stocked tanks. As far as ammonia and nitrite goes, shouldn't be a problem. Yeah, aerobic bacteria grows absolutely everywhere. You could really fill this with whatever you want and it would ensure zero ammonia, zero nitrite. We're actually after a full cycle though, not just half a job, so we're gonna change this a bit. But first I'm going to have a look in that pre-filter. I want to see some changes. I think that's coarser than the previous one. I haven't got the previous one to check though, but I think that is coarser. It's certainly coarse enough for a pre-filter. That is okay. The tube doesn't look any bigger though. It isn't any bigger. And I don't think there's any more holes. So down this side, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 holes, and 10 on the other side. So we've got 20 little holes, about 4 to 5 millimetres. So we've got 10 holes down each side. You could easily drill another 10 down these other sides. Just go opposite sides. In fact, you could drill as many holes as you want in there. Just make it like Swiss cheese. The easier it is for the water to pull through, the better the muck will be pulled into the foams, and really, the better the flow rate's going to be from this filter. That is very restrictive, so that is definitely going to get changed. I thought they wouldn't have changed that. So I took the liberty of drilling a piece of 20mm overflow pipe. Now you can get this from plumbing centres, DIY places, all that sort of thing. And for you guys in the US, that's 20mm is a metric version of 3/4 inch. I've made it the same length, give or take a couple of millimetres. But as you can see, the white one is much bigger diameter. The clear one that comes with this thing is about 1/2 inch diameter. This one is 20mm diameter. And I've also drilled all those extra holes. Now I hope this white one fits, because that's what I actually recommended people to use, or suggested people to use in the previous video. Took me quite a while to drill all those holes, so I possibly should have tried that before spending the time. But anyway, this one that comes with the filter fits inside this bit of pipe that comes out. And I'm kind of hoping that the white one will fit on the outside. Oh, it does. Oh yeah, that's a great fit. So that fits on the outside of that pipe that comes out of this pre-filter head. And if you're wondering what the black thing is in the end, it looks a little bit like a pool cue, doesn't it? That's just a piece of foam, roughly 1 inch by 4 inches. That I rolled up and shoved in the bottom, because the pre-filter foams have a hole all the way through and I don't want the water just to go straight up here. There you go. I just rolled that up and crammed it in the bottom. It doesn't want to be too long, because obviously you don't want to block the pipe up, but it needs to be long enough just to stop the water being all drawn up here. That's it. Right. So, our pre-filter foams can now go on here, and they do stretch over the 20mm pipe. Absolutely fine. If you wanted to mess about and try and cut the holes in there a little bit bigger, you could, but I'd suggest that it wouldn't be worth it. The fit on there, fine. That's it. And when you get them on, just check that they cover all of the holes. The last thing you want is a couple of holes near the top to be exposed without having a bit of foam on them, because the water's just going to fly through there and it's going to be dirty when it does. At least this will trap all the muck. So that goes back on there like so, and then that should fit back inside of there if I've got the length of it right. Spot on. Good stuff. Oh, actually, I forgot to thank Mehil for sending me this filter. Thank you very much. It will be going back to you fully pimped up. So we'll just need to see how much media we can get into here. So top tray, we'll leave that for the time being. We can take all this foam out. There's a there's really no comparison between using foam as a filter media compared to proper filter media as a filter media, you know, as far as how much bacteria it holds. And plastic filter media in a static environment is an abomination. So all that can come out. The medium pad that's at the very top, the post filtering pad, could stay in if you just want to catch any little bits of muck that might have made it that far. But I would suggest that you just put carbon or something like that in there, or even a carbon pad, or more media. I think in this instance, we may as well just go for more media. Let's just max it out. All those foams can go back. In fact, all of that can go back. I'm going to need a bigger box. And then in this bottom tray, because we've already got the coarse sponges in the pre-filter catching the heavy muck, really all we need in this bottom tray is a medium pad and a fine pad. So that's what we're going to put in here. As far as the rest of the trays go, they just want to be filled with the best media possible. Get whatever you can in your particular country or area. Here we're going to be using the Biohome Ultimate. That's the best one that I've got. It's the most suitable for the canister filters. In fact, it was designed specifically for canister filters. And you'll have seen it loads of times in my videos. I don't need to go on about it. It's a cracking media. As soon as I've done that, we'll take a look and see just how different this filter is. And I'll give you my thoughts on the size of tank that it would be suitable for. Actually, one thing I will mention before I tell you how much I've got in here, these trays fit together really, really well. You know, and because of the way that they fit together, water flows upwards. You're going to get very little chance of any sort of bypass in your trays, through your trays, should I say. Actually, on the subject of bypass, a lot of people will say, oh, my filter's bypassing, but it's because they use the fine pad last. That concentrates all the fine muck in the rest of the filter. That's why we put the fine pad at the bottom if the water's travelling up. If you have it at the top, your tray is filled with muck, and you think, oh my god, these trays are all bypassing, this filter's useless. Nope, it's just because you've got that in the wrong place. So on the subject of a fine pad, this is our bottom tray. In here, as you can see, we've got a nice thick fine pad. And underneath that, I've gone with the orange medium pad that would ordinarily be in the top tray. That's fine. You could go with the pond foam in the bottom of there, have the bumps down over, and then just cap it off with a fine pad. Really, this fine pad doesn't need to be quite as thick as this. It is a particularly thick one, but it will squash down well. So once the water gets through our pre-filter and through here, that's our mechanical filtration done. After that, unless you're using chemicals somewhere, it's all biological. Okay, so we've got 6 trays that are about the same size. One of them is being used for the mechanical filtration. That leaves 5 for media, plus our little skinny one on the top. Each one of these normal size trays takes a good 900 grams of Biohome Ultimate. That's about a pound for you guys in the US. Hold on, I made balls of that. Let's spin back. Each one of these main trays takes a good 900 grams of Biohome Ultimate. That's 2 pounds for each one of these trays. 2 pounds of media for each one of these trays for you guys in the US. Glad I realized that before I sent this filter back and started editing the video. So by the time we take the top tray into account, which has got about 500 grams or a pound, or just over a pound, that means that this entire filter will take 5 kilos of Biohome Ultimate, and that's about 11 pounds for you guys in the US. That's pretty good, and it puts it on par as far as media holding capabilities go with the FX6, the just about the Tetra 1200 EX or EX 1200. The Hydor Pro 600. The All Pond Solutions or Sun 2000 litre an hour filter, which I think's 525 gallons an hour filter for you guys in the US. I think that is the 404 or something, Sun 404, and in the UK it would be the All Pond Solutions EF2000 or EF2 Plus, or there's so many different names for filters. Anyway, it puts it on par with some pretty hefty filters, and this is probably the best made of all of them. Holds a little bit less than the equivalent Aqua L filters, which would be the Ultra 1400, which holds 6 kilos, and also a bit less than the Ultra Max 2000, which also holds 6 kilos, and a bit less than the Eheim 1200 XL, which also holds 6 kilos. So 5 kilos is a good result from this filter, because the trays are not a very nice shape, but they do hold quite a lot of media in total. So we'll get these dropped back in, and then I'll give you my final thoughts. Just put this heater back in case I forget to include it in the box. So this one holds 5 kilos. The 600 only held about 3.5 kilos. So this one therefore is suitable for a bigger tank. Oase say up to 850 liters. Yeah, if it's a fully planted tank and there's hardly any fish, yes, possibly. But we normally work on the rule of 1 kilo of media per 100 litres. 5 kilos of media means it's suitable for about 500 litres of a normally stocked tropical tank. If you've got goldfish, predators, discus, cichlids, that sort of thing, we class that as a heavily stocked tank, or marine also, we class that as a heavily stocked tank. You would halve that down to about 250 litres. And for you guys in the US, I don't know where my calculator is, my brain isn't very good, you'll find those conversions in the video description. So normally stock tank, 500 litres, heavily stock tank, 250 litres. And you've got the bonus of a really easy to remove pre-filter, not a big footprint. So as long as your cabinet under your tank has plenty of height to accommodate this fella, it doesn't take up much space laterally. Vertically? Yes. Not that way, not horizontally. Just bear in mind that the heater is only 400 watts, therefore, really, if that's the only heater that you're going to use in your system, it'll only do about 400 liters. Again, conversions are in the video description for you guys in the US, sorry. I kind of keep speaking in gallons and litres. UK gallons are actually different to US gallons as well, and people want to know what things are in UK gallons and US gallons. If I put everything in the video description or try to remember everything, it would just end up being like some astrophysicist nightmare, just of figures and numbers and brackets, and ugh, I'm not a maths person. So, in summary, this is another really good filter from Oase. I am glad that they went with a bigger version than the 600, because I thought the 600, with it only getting 3.5 kilos of media in, was quite limited. It needs media. This gives you, it gives you a bit more flow rate as well. You know, it's just a good filter. And as far as I know, it is available worldwide. Links over in the video description. I don't know how many times I've said that, but some people still ask where they can get things, and what I said here, there, and everywhere, and I'm like, links in video description. Okay, this is going to go back to Mehul. Mehul, M-E-H-U-L. Sorry, I'm pretty poor at pronouncing names. I'll say Mehul. And I hope he's pleased with it. I can't even remember what sort of tank it's going on. I get dozens and dozens of emails every day. I also spoke to him on the phone a few times as well, and my memory is fading. I'm getting old, you know. I can't remember exactly what situation this is going in, but hopefully it's big enough for his tank. I've explained here how much this will filter for a full cycle, which is zero ammonia, zero nitrite, and low, if hopefully zero nitrate as well. Also, on the subject of achieving a full cycle, just remember, avoid using products which claim to remove, detoxify or bind ammonia, nitrite and nitrate, because they do have a very profound starving effect on the bacteria. Even some simple conditioners that have those binding qualities that delay the cycle, or the first part of the cycle, which is to get to zero ammonia and zero nitrite, so badly, it might take more than 7 to 8 weeks just to get that first part done. It shouldn't take more than 2 or 3 with a normal conditioner that simply makes the water safe for life. So just bear that in mind. Avoid those products if you can, or if you want to achieve a full cycle. If you're not bothered and you just want zero ammonia, zero nitrite with a reduced amount of bacteria living in your filter, go for anything. It doesn't matter, but just look for a simple conditioner that makes the water safe. If it makes the water safe for life, that life includes bacteria, and it honestly does make a hell of a difference. On numerous occasions, I get phoned up by people who say, I've had a perfect cycle for years, zero, zero, zero. Has the Biohome stopped working? Because I've noticed that the nitrate has shot up. Through a process of elimination, we realise that they've simply just changed the conditioner to one with binding agents in. And I'm just like, it's starved the bacteria. That's why it's not been able to process all the waste, because the population of bacteria isn't there. What about swapping back to your old conditioner? It can't be that easy, can it? Yes, it can. A couple of months later, nitrate comes down because the population of bacteria has come back, and we're all happy again. And the happiest thing is the bacteria. Thanks for watching. I shall see you next time. And if you've got a filter that you want me to take a look at, please just phone me. My number is in the video description. I never look at texts. I never, ever look at texts. I cannot be fanning around on a phone, Instagram messages, no. Even comments, I kind of get to all the comments. Emails, I could possibly get to the emails, but it might be days later. Just phone me, you know. I can tell you if I've got videos backed up that have got your particular filter on, and therefore, you know, I wouldn't take it to upgrade for the videos. But if there's a one that I haven't done yet, and there is possibly still a few, by all means, I will take a look at it and include it in the video. And in the case of this one, you know, Mehul is getting 5 kilos Biohome Ultimate for nothing, which is a good deal. I get to make a video on this lovely filter. He gets a filter back, fully pimped up. Good deal. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Okay, laddie. That's the innie and that's the outie. Didn't it put your innie pipe on the outie and the outie on the innie?